Welcome to Elsevier Student Life. Today, we're going to walk you through how to redeem and access your Evolve resources for your eBook or online course. First, you'll want to check with your instructor to see if your resources will be hosted on Evolve or your school's LMS system. Next, visit evolve.elsevier.com to redeem your access code and access your resources.
Look for the section of the homepage that says Redeem an Access Code or enter an Evolve course ID. Copy your code into the text box, then click Submit. Check that the correct product title is displayed and click Redeem. From here, you'll be prompted to sign into Evolve. If you've previously created an Evolve account, please sign in at the top right corner of the page. You can reset your password if you need. If you're new to Evolve, create an account by filling out the required fields. Once you're logged into Evolve, you'll receive confirmation that your product is now available in your My Evolve content list. Click the Get Started link in the green box to move forward, or if your course is being hosted on your school's LMS, you can now log into your LMS and access your course. For those of you who selected Get Started, you'll be redirected to your My Evolve content list, home to all your Elsevier courses and textbooks. If your Evolve resources are part of an online course, select Enter Instructor's Course ID. Here, you'll either submit the course ID provided by your professor or follow the link to your school's LMS system. In this example, the Evolve resources are not directly linked to an instructor's online course, so we'll continue by clicking the link Evolve Resources for Maternity and Women's Healthcare 12th Edition. Because we're accessing these resources independently, not by the instruction of a professor who will be grading us, we'll ignore the warning and click Proceed with Caution. Now, we're officially inside the Evolve Resources for Maternity and Women's Healthcare. The next step, click Student Resources to see what's offered for this text. Now that we're in the Student Resources folder, we can see that our resources are separated by chapter and by category. First, we're going to check out the Audio Glossary resource for Maternity and Women's Healthcare. Here, we'll find an alphabetized list of every key term in the course. We can search for the term we're looking for, click on it, and find great condensed summaries with the option to play it out loud. This feature is especially useful when learning to pronounce terms that are difficult to sound out. Now, let's go back to the Evolve Student Resources folder for this course. Note that the audio glossary will pop up in a separate tab on your browser, so you'll need to exit out or minimize it and return to your tabs instead of clicking the back arrow. This week, we've been learning about assessment and health promotion in this course. So, we're interested to see what Evolve resources are available for this chapter. Now that we've opened the Chapter 4 folder, we can see there's plenty of resources to help better understand this section of the course. First, let's check out the answers to clinical reasoning case study. Once we click the link, a new tab opens up. At the bottom left corner of the screen, a Word document appears in the downloads with the content we're looking for. If your web browser doesn't reveal the document in the same way this one does, check the downloads folder of your computer. Now, we're going to exit out of this tab and navigate back to the Chapter 4 Resources folder. The process we went through to access and download the Answers to Clinical Reasoning case study document will remain the same for case studies and key points. Reviewing these documents will really enforce what we've learned in this course thus far and help to prepare for upcoming exams. Now, before we start reviewing assessment and health promotion, we want to see what we already know. Let's click on the Quiz NCLEX Chapter 4 link to see where we stand. The chapter quiz will pop up in a new tab. Since this is our first time taking it, we only have the option to begin quiz. If we'd taken this quiz previously, there would be other options such as continue where we left off or reset quiz. Let's click Begin Quiz and get started. At the top left corner of the screen, we can see that there's 10 questions to answer in this section. Select the circle that you think is the right answer for each question and click Submit. Once you finish the quiz, you'll immediately receive a score in the Overview tab. Clearly, we have a lot of studying to do. But before we jump into the resources we just downloaded, let's review the questions we got right and wrong. When we click on the Incorrect tab, we can see which answer is selected and why it's incorrect. We can also see which is the correct answer indicated by the green arrow and why it's correct. Moving over to the Correct tab, we can see the questions we got right. As you can see, Elsevier has provided us with rationale for each answer option, further enforcing our understanding of the question and its related concepts. To navigate back to our chapter resources, we'll exit out of the quiz tab. From here, we can either return to all the student resources for this course by clicking Student Resources or the back arrow, or we can navigate back to the Evolve content list by clicking My Content. And there you have it. Now you're all set up to access your course's Evolve resources and truly excel in the content areas.
Elsevier supports your student life. Make sure to follow us on social media for more great resources and subscribe to our channel today so you never miss a practice question.